Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And I thank my colleague, Mr. Vargas, for yielding me time to speak, and I support his amendment. I also support this bill more generally because it supports the quiet heroes in our intelligence community. They don't seek public praise. In fact, they shun it. And while others enjoy the limelight, they work hard in the shadows. Section 1511 is a version of legislation I wrote called the POISE Act. I filed it after the president disclosed highly sensitive information to Russian officials at a White House meeting. This information had been entrusted to the U.S. by a key ally. Section 1511, drawing on the POISE Act, says Congress must be notified when a member of the executive branch, including the president, discloses top secret information to an adversary government outside established intelligence channels. As a former national security specialist at the Department of Defense, I know these disclosures are dangerous because our adversary could use the information to harm U.S. interests, and our partners could stop sharing intelligence if they don't trust us to keep it confidential. The congressional notification requirement will deter irresponsible disclosures and enable Congress to conduct oversight and limit any damage caused by the disclosure. I also wanted to express my disappointment on a matter of national security. Congressman Curbelo and I offered a bipartisan amendment to require the DNI to report to Congress on the national security threat posed by deep fake technology and how the intelligence community will counter it. Deep fake technology is the digital falsification of images, video, and audio to portray an individual as having done or said something he or she didn't say or do. Senator Rubio has raised alarms about how foreign intelligence services could use deep fake technology to undermine our nation's security and democracy. Frankly, I was dismayed our amendment was not ruled in order despite being supported by the Intelligence Committee. I know the Rules Committee often makes decisions for reasons unrelated to policy, but the exclusion of this amendment was a serious mistake, and I will look for other ways to ensure our country is prepared for the emerging threat posed by deepfake technology. Thank you, and I yield back.